compute del cross V dot n d sigma over the hemisphere x square plus y square plus z square equals a square where z is greater than or equal to 0 where v is given by 4yi plus xj plus 2zk. Okay, all right. So when you're giving this integral, right, this is a curl of v. So whenever you see a curl of v, you can always reduce it to an integral over the bounding curve, right? And since this is a hemisphere, which means it's an open surface, so whenever you see open surface and a curl and an integral over the curl of a vector field, immediately think of Stokes' theorem. Okay, so what is the Stokes' theorem? So the Stokes' theorem is this is an integral over sigma del cross v dot n d sigma is equal to, so this is curve bounding sigma. Okay, so this is dou sigma v dot d r. Okay, all right. So we know what v is. V is 4yi plus xj plus 2zk. And what is dr? Dr is nothing but, by now you should know, so that is I dx plus j dy plus z, sorry, plus k dz. Okay, so this is your dr. So v dot dr is going to be 4y dx plus x dy plus 2z dz. Alright. Now we have been given equation of hemisphere. Equation of hemisphere. What is equation of hemisphere? X square plus y square plus z square is equal to a square. This is given. So from here we can calculate 2x dx. We can take the differential. Okay, so we'll get 2x dx plus 2y dy plus 2z dz is equal to 0. Right, so we have 2z dz is nothing but minus 2x dx minus 2y dy. Okay, now what we do? In v of dr, we substitute this. So we will get v dot dr is equal to 4y dx plus x dy minus 2x dx minus 2y dy. So this reduces to 4y minus 2x dx plus x minus 2y. Okay, and what was our Stokes theorem? Stokes theorem told us that del cross v dot n d sigma integral over the sigma is equal to integral over dou sigma with the bounding curve, right? This is open surface and this is the bounding curve. Okay, v dot dr. Alright. So we need to find out dou sigma v dot dr. So what is this? This is going to be dou sigma. By the way, what is dou sigma for a hemisphere? Dou sigma for the bounding curve for a hemisphere is a circle. Okay, in this case of radius a. All right, so this is going to be 4y minus 2x dx plus x minus 2y dy. All right, so this is, so what does this look like? When you see this now, this is nothing but of the form p dx plus q dy, right? So now you can use your Green's theorem, okay? So what does Green's theorem tell us? We can reduce it to dou q by dou x minus dou p by dou y dx dy, okay? All right. So let's define p and q again. So p was 4y minus 2x and q is x minus 2y. So dou p by dou y is 4, dou q by dou x is 1. Okay, so this is going to reduce to one minus 4 into dx dy. Okay. Alright. So this is going to be minus 3 dx dy, and this is over the circle. Right. Okay, so this is now your area of the circle. So what is the area, what is area of the circle? Area of the circle is pi a square. So ultimately you are going to get minus 3 pi a square. Okay, and this is area of the circle. Alright. So hope this is clear. So you can use all of these different formulas to find out the value of the integrals. And all of these three, Green's theorem, Stokes theorem and divergence theorems, all of these are related to one another. And this is the way that you can calculate the various integrals. Okay. Del cross V dot n d sigma. Double integral over this over sigma. So this was around over the area of the open surface, right? And this we were trying to solve, and we had, all we had was that the surface represents hemisphere given by x square plus y square plus z square equals a square. Okay, this was given, and v, the vector field itself, was given by yi plus xj plus 2zk. Okay, this is what was given to us. So in the previous lecture we saw how we can use Stokes theorem. So Stokes theorem is given by del cross v dot n d sigma is equal to v dot dr over the closed loop dou sigma. Okay, so this was our Stokes theorem, and what we wanted to solve this part, but instead of actually solving this part, we ended up solving this part, right? So since we ended up solving this part, so now let us see how to solve the LHS. So we will, so of course LHS and RHS should be the same. So ultimately we should get the answer as minus 3 pi a square. But just to show you that we can all also use it, also straight away calculate this part, which is the LHS. So how do we calculate this? So we want to calculate del cross V dot n d sigma. So first of all, let's calculate what is del cross V. How will you calculate del cross V? Del cross V will be what? I j k, right? Dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, vx, vy, vz. This is our del cross V. Okay, so this is going to be I j k dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z. And what is vx? Vx is our 4y, vy is x, and vz is 2z. Okay, remember we are getting vx, vy, vz from our vector field, okay, which is this. So this is your vx, this is your vy, and this is your vz. Okay, all right, so let's compute this determinant. So we are going to have I dou by dou y of 2z minus dou by dou y of minus dou by dou z. Dou z of x plus j into dou by dou x have to just compute the determinant. So this is minus j into dou by dou x of 2z minus dou z of 4y plus k into dou by dou x of x minus dou by dou y of 4y. So all the j terms will be 0, all the I terms will be 0. So ultimately you will be left with dou by dou x of x is 1, dou by dou y of 4y is 4. So you will be left with del cross V is equal to minus 3k. So this is going to be our del cross V. Now we have to find n. Okay, so what is n? N is a unit normal vector pointing outward from the surface. Okay, and what is the surface? Surface is our hemisphere. Okay, and the equation of hemisphere is given by x square plus y square plus z square equals a square. So this is our surface. Okay, so how will you find n? So for any given surface, okay, so phi, let's call phi as x square plus y square plus z square minus a square. Okay, so this is our surface. Okay, all right, so for any given surface, n would be del phi, or you can say grad phi, by norm of grad phi. Okay, all right, so how will you find del phi now? So what is del phi? Del phi is nothing but I dou by dou x of phi plus j dou by dou y of phi plus k dou by dou z of phi. Okay, and by del phi. Okay, so our del phi is nothing but this term on in the numerator. So what is dou by dou x of phi? It is 2x. So you'll get 2xi plus 2yj plus 2zk. Okay, this is going to be your del phi. And what is the norm of del phi? Norm of del phi is nothing but four x square plus four y square plus four z square whole square. Okay, root of the entire thing. And so this will be, and x square plus y square plus z square we know is a square. So we can write it as 4a square. So this turns out to be 2a. Okay. So now we find n. So now we can find n, and this is going to be given by del phi by norm of del phi. So we are going to have 2xi plus 2yj plus 2zk by 2a, which is nothing but xi plus yj plus zk by a. Now what is xi plus yj plus zk in general? This is given as r by a. Okay. So we have del cross v dot n d sigma, or we'll worry about d sigma later. So let's first worry about n. Okay, del cross v dot n is now your minus 3k dot r by a. Okay, so what is minus 3k dot r by a? Only the kth component will be there. So you are going to have minus 3z by a. So this is your del cross v dot n. Now we need to find out this double integral n d sigma over sigma. Okay, so we have minus 3z by a d sigma over sigma. So this is the integral that we need to compute. Now remember that this object over which we are computing this integral is actually a hemisphere. Okay, so we have this hemisphere. Alright, so if we have a hemisphere, we can convert it to spherical coordinates. Okay, so your x and y coordinates, x, y, z coordinates can be converted to spherical coordinates. Alright, so let's see. So if this is our origin, this is going to be our z axis, this is going to be our y axis, this is going to be our x axis. Okay, now the angle that any point on this surface makes with the z axis is your angle theta, and the angle that the projection of this makes with the xy plane is your angle phi. Alright, this we know from spherical coordinates. So all we have to do is we have to convert d sigma. So we have to find what is d sigma. Okay, so because this is only the area element, right, this is the area element with radius constant. So radius is a. Okay, this we know from the surface equation of the surface that was given to us, which was x square plus y square plus z square equals a square. So radius is constant at a. So all we need to find out is d sigma for spherical coordinates is going to be a square sine theta d theta d5. Okay, all right. And theta will go from 0 to pi by 2. Why? Because theta is the angle that the vector r, right? So this is your vector r. So that the vector r makes with the z axis. And because this is a hemisphere, the only angle it can make is from 0 to pi by 2. Okay, and phi is your, phi goes fully along the circle. So this is going to be 0 to 2 pi. Alright, so now let's compute this integral. So we are going to have, this is going to be 5 phi goes from 0 to 2 pi and theta goes from 0 to pi by 2 and minus 3 z by a into sine theta d theta d phi. Now you have to also see what is z. So z also needs to be converted to polar coordinates. So z in the spherical coordinates is given by r cos theta, and because r is equal to a, we have z is equal to a cos theta. So instead of z, we should write here a cos theta. A cos theta. So a gets cancelled and we are left with the integral 0 to 2 pi d phi 0 to pi by 2 minus 3 cos theta sine theta d phi. Okay. So when you see this cos theta sine theta, you can reduce it to something else. Okay, so you can also compute d phi because theta does not depend on the phi variable. So this is an independent integral. So this will give you minus 3 phi goes from 0 to pi, and now you are left with 0 to pi by 2 cos theta sine theta d theta. Okay, so I am continuously writing theta phi, d phi twice, so let's erase that. Okay, d phi I have already written d phi over here. Alright, so if you see such small typo like things, please let me know. Anyway, so now we have this. So what we can do is we can multiply and divide by 2. So this will reduce to, so this, let's compute this. So we have minus 3 to 2 pi minus 0. And now you have 2, 0 to pi by 2. And 2 sine theta cos theta is nothing but sine 2 theta d theta. Okay. So let's compute. So so the integral that we have is minus 3 by 2 into 2 pi into sine 2. So what is the solution for integral of sine 2 theta? This is going to be 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 cos 2 theta. Okay. Now this theta goes from 0 to pi by 2. Okay. So we are going to have, when we solve this integral, we are going to have plus 3 by 4 and cos pi is minus 1 to 2 pi, and this is minus 1 and cos 0 is minus is 1, so minus 1 minus 1. So we will have three right? Minus 3 by 4 into 4 pi. Okay, we missed something here. What did we miss? So I told you that d sigma is a square sine theta d theta d phi. So where is a square? I think we missed writing a square. So there is an a square everywhere, right? Into a square. So we have a square here, and we have a square. So this reduces to equals minus 3 pi a square. So you see that we get the same answer no matter how we do it. Either we calculate the double integral or we calculate the integral over the bounded loop. Okay. So this is an example for using Stokes theorem, or when Stokes theorem is applied. Evaluate the integral. Yi minus xj plus zk dot dr around the circumference of the circle of radius 2, center at the origin, in the xy plane. Okay, so now you can, in this integral, you see this is of the form v dot dr. Okay, this is of the form dou sigma v dot dr. Okay, so if this is of the form v dot dr, you know that you can actually either use Stokes theorem or you can use the property of the circle, right, to get this integral. So of course, if this bounded, so this bounded curve is the circle. Okay, so bounded curve is the circle, but it is of the form v dot dr, which means the surface is an open surface. So for an open surface, you can assume if the bounded is a circle, then the open surface might be like a hemisphere. And so for the hemisphere, you can calculate the integral del cross v dot n d sigma. And this is over the area sigma. Okay, so this is nothing but your Stokes theorem. Okay, so I have given you enough hints, so you should know how to, you can do it.